So you guys have definitely been hitting your abs pretty hardcore in your body rock workouts. In today's body rock flow workout, we are going to not only target those muscles that will, you know, help give you the six pack, but we're also going to work a different muscle. It's called the psoas. You may or may not be familiar with it. It runs in the deep into the core of your body. It's responsible for giving you strength, but it's also responsible for helping you to, with all of your movements, with your breath, even it's even important for good digestion. So we're gonna hit that one, especially with this first exercise. So this first posture is called extended leg raise posture or pose. You're gonna start just by raising you're gonna have your legs a couple inches off the ground, toes are pointed. You wanna try not to arch your back. So what you're trying to do is ground the small of your back into the floor. They teach you that in Pilates. So you're taking this part of your back and you're pushing it down. As soon as you do that, you're gonna feel your abs get tight. So try to keep the small of your back down. Bring your legs up, point your toes. So you're gonna lower your legs with the exhale to wherever you can maintain the small of the back staying down. If you start to bring your legs down and your back arches, then you're going a little too far. So with your legs straight over your hips, start to lower, keep the small of your back down. Go as low as you can, inhale, bringing your legs back up. Exhale. Back up. So go as far as you can. Keep the small of your back down. Try to do 20 of those. Bringing your legs back down, we're going to start our next one by extending the arms over the head. Just cross your thumbs, palms facing the ceiling. Again, you're going to ground the small of your back into the mat, into the floor. So you're not lifting like this. There should be no space underneath your body, underneath your lower spine. So you're grounding your lower back. You're going to inhale and roll up. Exhale to bring yourself down. Inhale. You might be able to go all the way down towards your knees. Exhale, one vertebrae at a time. Coming all the way back down. You may not be able to go up that far, maybe just something like this. Go as far as you can. Keep your arms with your ears. Keep the small of your back down.
So people are probably gonna wanna just collapse at the end and roll down really fast.
Yes. Try to do it controlled. So you might not be able to in the beginning, but just doing your best, that can be another thing you could clock in your fit test, perhaps. So see if you can do lower spine, mid spine, finally upper spine, cervical spine, your neck, and then up. Same thing, reverse. The lower back comes off the floor first, the shoulders last. Again, try for at least 20 of those. Okay, third one. So start with your feet on the floor. There's a tendency in this one for the lower back to round. There's a tendency for the chest to collapse forward. We want to try not to do either of those things. So you're trying to lift your chest and to keep your back nice and straight. A beginner version of this would just be lifting the legs to here. If you can, you're lifting your arms as well. Try to bring your chest towards your legs without, again, letting your lower back round and without letting your chest collapse, holding for 5 breaths. It's a tough one. This is also really good for your lower back. So if you think you might have lower back muscles that are kind of weak, or if you've noticed that doing your body rock flow test or during your body rock flow test, then this will help to strengthen your lower back while you're, again, working the abs, while you're working the core. Beginner version, intermediate, or even kind of advanced. Really advanced version of this, You could grab your heels. You might not be able to straighten your legs. Think of straightening your legs and bringing your chest towards your shins, your face towards your shins. Chest towards your thighs, face towards your shins. See how my back is rounding a bit? Try not to. Chest up, lower back long, forehead to shins. So far the general rule that we're coming up with for how long to hold these body rock flow postures or movements is 5 breaths. So you're holding stillness for 5 breaths. The definition actually of posture or of asana is holding stillness, breathing normal. So you're trying to find that place of stillness for you, your edge, hold for 5 breaths. If you're doing a movement, we'll always let you know how many reps we're doing, but otherwise just keeping in mind 5 breaths. So you're inhaling, you're exhaling, always through the nose, and really start to pay attention to your breathing always. That's really, really key to yoga. It's fundamental. I want to talk to you a little bit about the power of an intention or having intentions. You could set an intention before your yoga practice. You could set an intention before you do your workout. You could wake up in the morning and set an intention for your day. An intention for your day might be just to meet people on the street, with kindness, or to hold the door open for as many people as you can throughout the day. I like to do that one. Sometimes it's quite fun because people don't expect it, and it's nice just to do that kind of stuff. And then see the reactions when it's such a simple thing. That might be an intention for your day. You might have an intention before you do your body rock workout, an intention to really, get strong, or to do the best that you can to build your strength. In the yoga workouts, it could be to increase your flexibility, or it also could be something simpler. Being aware of your breathing. So are you breathing in and out of these exercises? The breath is really important. And the breath is also the best tool that we have to the present moment, to being present. So it's just a good idea to think bigger. So for example, in the video we just did, we're working our abs. When you go to do your abdominal workout, you may not just want to focus on, oh, I'm doing this because I really want to get a six pack. But instead you could be, focusing on, well, I'm strengthening that muscle, that psoas muscle, which isn't just going to give me a six pack, but it's also going to help with a lot of my other bodily kind of movements and functions and organs and glands. So just, want to throw out there too that, yoga is about a lot more than just the physical or the muscles that are working, but again, we're tapping into the metaphysical too. We're moving beyond the physical body more and more in time, and really getting in touch with our inner selves.